I don't see any reason why not.
Okay, thank you. Bye-bye. Oh yeah, wait, before I go.
This charity bake sale, what is it supposed to benefit?
Oh, I dislike talking about gruesome subjects. When you get right down to it, all charity is pretty ugly, isn't it?
I don't follow.
Ask Mr. Moynihan. He's organized this event. In conjunction with the lodge, naturally.
Well, off to see Stephanie.
Give my regards to your parents.
Well, let's have a look here. Alrighty. Yeah, she's pretty. That's special. Youch. Yeah, you can always use some good old-fashioned loop, I guess. Let's hope they don't notice these things missing. Let's see. Okay. Tampons. Yeah, that's brilliant. Go ask Stephanie about the tampons. Well, that's enough of that, I guess. Oh, wait, this. Alrighty then, I'll take a note of that. Let's have a look at that picture. It's crooked. Oh boy. Yeah, we all know what this means, right? Mr. Potsdam loves fondling his meat. Nothing special here, I guess. So, nice place.
Who are you? What are you doing in my room?
Wait a second.
Heard? We're getting married.
So, you're the one. Steve, isn't it?
You mean, you don't know me?
I mean, I don't know anyone. I don't remember anything. How many times do I have to say it?
Oh. Just one, Stephanie, because I can't remember a damn thing either.
Really? Oh God, I thought it was just me.
Nope.
You're not alone. Can you tell me what's going on here?
Those people downstairs have locked me in my room. They say I'm grounded until the wedding.
Oh boy. So,
they claim to be my parents. I can't dispute it because I can't remember for sure one way or the other, but it doesn't feel right.
Well, after meeting the people I met, it totally makes sense.
Do you have any idea where you do belong?
No, but I'm fairly sure I don't belong in Harvest.
Yeah. I can't remember anything, but I feel in my heart that the woman downstairs is not my mother. She's like this thing. Like a parody. A bad joke with mother as the punchline. Does that make any sense?
Yes, actually it does make a lot of sense.
I'm glad I'm not the only one who sees it that way. I thought I was going crazy.
Join the club. But we can't both be crazy, Stephanie.
Either way, something really weird is going on here. I've got to escape. And so do you. Because in a way, whether you know it or not, I think we're both grounded.
In a way, she's actually right.
It's been hell. They treat me well, but they won't let me leave this room. Not even to go out in the yard. Not until the wedding.
They won't tell you why?
Each one blames the other for grounding me. They make up different excuses. Different things I did, none of which I remember. So I sit up here, watch the world outside my window, and listen to the noises in the house.
Oh boy.
Every morning, a weird boy comes to the house and picks up the paper. He doesn't deliver the paper. He picks up scrap paper that Miss Potsdam sets out on the porch for him. Some mornings she forgets, and the boy gets furious. Gives me the creeps.
Anything else you can tell me?
I hear these weird scraping sounds in the bathroom sometimes. Like something is sliding along the wall. Claws, maybe. And Mr. Potsdam, I don't like the way my dear daddy looks at me. Both of them are always watching me. Especially him.
You don't think they're dangerous, do you?
I think this whole place is dangerous. I think we've got to escape. Before it's too late.
Yeah. Let's tell her. Peephole. There we go.
Stephanie, I think you should know. There's a peephole hidden behind the picture in the bathroom.
You mean a peephole? They're spying on me?
Uh-huh. I'm afraid so.
So that's the scraping I hear every night. The picture sliding along the wall. Oh, disgusting. I've got to get out of here, Steve. The thought of that fat slob watching me.
I'll question Potsdam about it. Maybe if he knows I know, it'll scare him off.
Thank you, Steve. I don't know what I'd do without you.
Well, given that she barely knows Steve, she just met him.
Come back and visit me soon, okay?
Sure. Let's go talk to Mr. Potsdam about the peeping hole. Confronting the peeping Tom.
If it isn't my favorite son-in-law, what brings you here again,